you suggesting that I killed my wife? You saying that I crushed her skull and that I shot her? How dare you? When I came home, there was a man in my house. I fought with this man. He had a mechanical arm. You find this man. You find this man.
How tall is he?
Everything from me. Oh, Jesus.
What do you weigh?
God!
What color was his hair? What color were his eyes?
Don't you realize? The next time you see Sky, it'll be over another town. The next time you take a test, it'll be in some other school. Our parents, they want the best of stuff for us. But right now, they gotta do what's right for them. Cause it's their time. Their time. Up there. Down here, it's our time. It's our time down here. That's all over the second we ride up Troy's bucket.
Dr. Brown, on the night that I go back in time, you will be shot by terrorists. Please take whatever precautions are necessary to prevent this terrible disaster. Your friend, Marty.
That was the end of Grogan, the man who killed my father, raped and murdered my sister, burned my ranch, shot my dog, and stole my Bible.
Jones. So this is what becomes of us. Eric was right. Humanity does this to us.
Not if we show them a better path.
You still believe?
Just because someone stumbles, loses their way, it doesn't mean they're lost forever. Sometimes we all need a little help.
Oh, I'm not the man I was. I open my mind, and it almost overwhelms me.
You're afraid, and Cerebro knows it.
All those voices. So much pain.
It's not that pain you're afraid of. It's yours, Charles. And as frightening as it may be, that pain will make you stronger. If you allow yourself to feel it, embrace it, it will make you more powerful than you ever imagined. It's the greatest gift we have, to bear their pain without breaking. And it's born from the most human power. Hope. Please, Charles, we need you to hope.
Which direction we are going. There's no knowing where we're rowing, or which way the river's flowing. Is it raining? Is it snowing? Is a hurricane a-blowing? Not a speck of light is showing, so the danger must be growing. Are the fires of hell a-glowing? Is the grisly reaper mowing? Yes! The danger must be growing, for the rowers keep on rowing, and they're certainly not showing any signs that they are slowing!
The Matrix is a system, Neo. That system is our enemy. But when you're inside, you look around, what do you see? Businessmen, teachers, lawyers, carpenters, the very minds of the people we are trying to save. But until we do, these people are still a part of that system, and that makes them our enemy. You have to understand, most of these people are not ready to be unplugged. And many of them are so inert, so hopelessly dependent on the system, that they will fight to protect it. Every single man or woman who has stood their ground, everyone who has fought an agent has died. But where they have failed, you will succeed.
Why?
I've seen an agent punch through a concrete wall. Men have emptied entire clips at them and hit nothing but air. Yet their strength and their speed are still based in a world that is built on rules. Because of that, they will never be as strong or as fast as you can be.
What are you trying to tell me? That I can dodge bullets?
No, Neo. I'm trying to tell you that when you're ready, you won't have to.
Balanced equation inherent to the programming of the Matrix. You are the eventuality of an anomaly which, despite my sincerest efforts, I have been unable to eliminate from what is otherwise a harmony of mathematical precision. While it remains a burden assiduously avoided, it is not unexpected and thus not beyond a measure of control, which has led you inexorably here.
You haven't answered my question.
Quite right. Interesting. That was quicker than the others.
Others? How many? Others? What? Answer.
The Matrix is older than you know. I prefer counting from the emergence of one integral anomaly to the emergence of the next, in which case this is the sixth version.
Five lines before me.
There are only two possible explanations.
There were five ones before me.
Either no one told me.
Or no one.
Precisely. As you are undoubtedly gathering, the anomaly is systemic, creating fluctuations in even the most simplistic equations.
Do not grieve. Soon, I shall be one with the Matrix.
Prime.
Ultra Magnus. It is to you, old friend. I shall pass the Matrix of leadership as it was passed to me.
But Prime, I'm just a soldier. I'm not worthy.
Nor was I. But one day, an Autobot shall rise from our ranks and use the power of the Matrix to light our darkest hour. Till that day, till all. one. Now I enter these hallowed halls, a conqueror. Yes. Autobots and Decepticons, still frozen in emergency stasis, awaiting the moment 4 million years hence, when they will awaken to start the Great War. The Great War. Will the Autobots defeat the Decepticons? And thus their descendants, the Maximals, rule we Veticons? Archaic energon guzzlers. How dare they? Unwilling though I was to follow my namesake's instructions, it has all come down to this. The ultimate risk for the ultimate prize. A day of reckoning with those who made us slaves. So, we are now face to face, Optimus Prime. In one future, you awaken and become the great leader of the Autobots. But time shall take a different track now. Computer! All available power to primary weapon!
Weapon power to maximum.
And now, Optimus Prime, in memory of the Decepticons, for the glory of the Predacons, for the Cybertron that is rightfully ours, and mine to rule, I unleash the storm of vengeance! Farewell! Say goodbye to the universe, Maximals! The future has changed! Yes! The Autobots lose! Evil triumphs! And you no